Hello all and welcome back to World of Tanks with Black Nike. This will be my second review of the German tank destroyers. And today I'm going to review the Tier 8 German tank destroyer that will be coming out in patch 8.9. So, the RHM Borsigwaffenträger. It's a low profile tank with almost no armor, and it's got a turret mounted on top of the body. So the first thing that notices me is that it's got 1150 health points or hit points. It has more hit points than the Russian tank destroyers, and if I'm right, it will have about the same amounts of the American tank destroyers at tier 8 have. That's, yeah, 1150 for the T-28 prototype and same amount for T-28. And looking at the Jagdpanzer 2, it has also has 1150 hit points, and the Ferdinand has 50 hit points more. So, compared to the rest of the tank destroyers, it got a lot of hit points, as well as, oh no, it's got less than the AT-15, but the AT-15 is very slow, so it makes this point. But 1150 hit points for such a low profile tank, and it has a turret which has no armor at all. So, it's quite a lot of hit points for such a small and low armored tank destroyer. It weighs 18.5 ton with a limit of 23 tons, because you still can load some modules. It can mount multiple guns, both tier 10, the 12.8 or the 15 centimeter. It has 207 horsepower engine, which is enough for the weight it has. It has a speed limit of 35 kph and a traverse speed of 42 degrees per second. Well, as I said, it has no hull armor, reflected in its 20 mm front, 10 mm in the side, and 8 mm in the rear. With the gun I've got mounted, it has an average damage of 750 hit points. With the 12.8, it has an average damage of 490 damage. But it has a higher fire rate and more penetration then. The gun's reverse speed is 24 degrees per second, but it's a complete turret, so you will turn turret and body together at over 60 degrees per second. It's got a fuel range of 400 meters and a signal range of 700 meters, which is both well enough to be able to see your enemy when they get spotted. So, over to the modules. We have a tier 8 Trax here with 42 degrees per second. Stuck, it will have 38 degrees per second with 21 tons of load limit. So the load limit will not be a problem, but the traverse speed will be a problem. Its guns, we already watched that, so I'm not going to look at that for you. And an engine, you will start with a tier 4 engine stock mounted on it with 180 horsepower, and the upgraded engine will be only tier 5 with 207 horsepower. Its radio, it will have three choices of radios. Stock mounted radio will have up to 400 meters of signal range, only a tier 6 radio, so that's no surprise. And upgrade, you can upgrade to the radio Fug 8, It's a tier 8 radio with 550 meters radius, also mounted on the tier 7 and tier 6 tank destroyers, and also on a tier 5, if I'm right. And the top radio, tier 8 as well, will have up to 700 meters of signal range. So, I'm using the 15 centimeter puck because using 12.8, your tank destroyer won't have a full use of its capabilities. You won't be able to do the damage you want to do. You won't be able to assist your team enough. It's not as accurate as it should be, the 12.8, and the 15 centimeter is just a little bit less accurate, but it does a lot more damage. Although it has less penetration, being at tier 8 and having an average penetration of 250 millimeters, you will have enough penetration to penetrate most enemy vehicles. If you're not penetrating them, it's either that you are not aiming your shots well enough, or the enemy is just not showing its weak spots to you. So, let's do some games with this tank, and I will show you live recordings from some of the games I will have played with this tank destroyer. So, here I'm in a tier 9 game with 5 tier 9 tanks in my team and 6 tier 9 tanks against me. And I'm going to look for an opportune place to put my tank. Being able to snipe is quite important, but also going to be able to fire at the enemy without being spotted will be my major point. Going to the hill won't be smart for me because they do have a T-54 and an SU-122-54, and I'm not going to be fast enough to get to the hill in time. But I am able to be going to some spots that will get me sniping positions at multiple spots. I'm probably already lit up by that light tank there. Yep. I think I just got shot by a teammate. Yep. And someone manages to shoot me, but not damage me. So I'm actually kind of lucky to have survived that. Because of my stupid teammate who shot me. Well, seeing this is the test server, that actually shows you that stupid teammates are more dangerous when playing this tank than stupid enemies. That I survived that is, yeah, actually quite amazing. But seeming I lost a track and my engine, I will not be going far. Okay, the enemy new tank destroyer just drowned itself. I'm trying to get to the right spot, but I'm able to get spotted very easily out here, so I'm not going to take any risks. So, now I'm in an excellent sniping position, but seeming I don't have a lot of view range, and Mr. Fritz there is already about 300 meters away, I will not be spotting very much or seeing very much of the enemy. I can't hit that tier 9 tank destroyer. So, there will be quite a lot of that in this game, probably. I'm also not able to hit that heavy tank out there. And in the meanwhile, our tanks are being shot at from almost every side. Wow, he just got that IS-3 just got two shot by the enemy because they have so much of those tank destroyers of them. Our team killer actually gets a lot of use in this game as well, so I don't blame him now for having hit me. And seeming this is just a test server game, I'm not going to report anyone for, yeah, accidentally hitting a teammate. Because I know he was shooting at an enemy. I'm actually drowning here. I don't know how I can drown out here. How did I drown? Well, that game ended in a draw, and since I was drowned at a spot I shouldn't be actually drowned, I didn't do a lot. Actually, I didn't do anything. But my teammate who shot me did have to pay me quite a lot of credits. I did get 5,000 compensation because he damaged me. Well, if he wouldn't have damaged me, I probably wouldn't have been tracked, and I probably wouldn't have lost my engine. But seeming the engine in this device will be hit a lot, we will just try again. Well, this is my second game, and quite unfortunate, I am the only tier 8 tank destroyer, or tier 8 normal tank, if you could put it that way, in a tier 10 game. We do have tier 8 artillery, but yeah, I'm not glad that I'm matched up with artillery. Seeing the teams, I see 6 new Waffenträgers auf E100 and two of the Borsig Waffenträgers. I'm one of the two. So we're moving out, and as you'd expect, tank destroyers that will be trying to go to a sniping position are moving up as fast as they can because they've got an E50M that can spot us quite fast. So the faster we get up the hill, the less chance of getting killed by artillery and being destroyed without doing anything. And seeming this tank is, it's little, it's low weight, but its power to weight ratio is also very bad. And those Waffenträgers auf E100 have quite a lot of more horsepower under the hood. So there we have a Foch. There's the E50M. Now I have to move very, very, very fast. Artillery is already shooting my team. I'm taking a position to hit that E50M if he gets around the corner. Yeah, there he is. 800 damage. Now I'm being completely obliterated.840 damage. But now I'm dead. This game, I'm totally useless. And that my team isn't coming to help me is, well, it's just so bad. I wouldn't expect my team to actually help me, but seeming that most of the time new tank destroyers are very valuable, you should think about helping them and not letting them stay on their own at some places and get killed because you are too afraid to die. Well, we're behind 3-6 now, so we're actually getting back a little bit, but yeah, team sucks so hard. That E50M is still alive, and I got two shots in him. He shouldn't be alive at this stage. He actually had to be dead by that Waffenträger enemy teammate. So, we practically lost this game already, and it doesn't matter what our team does now, they can't make this game any better. I was actually hoping for a team that would be able to do something. So I could show you what the strong points are of those new tank destroyers, but I just showed you exactly the opposite. I've showed you the how badly armored these tanks are, and well, it's just not possible to bounce anything or use anything as somewhat cover. You're just going to be shot at by everything and being penetrated by everything, and well, being able to do a huge amount of damage with one shot just isn't enough to save your own hide. Exactly, not against a tier 10 medium tank. I could three shot an E50M or a Patton 3 or any other tier 10 medium tank, but they can shoot so fast with 400 damage or 300 damage that my damage just doesn't care anymore. That I can do 750 damage or 800 damage in one shot is, yeah, they're not afraid of me. They're just going to be like, oh yeah, he can put one shot into me, and then I'll move forward and move three shots into him. And I did 900 damage or 1200 damage. He only did 800 damage. But you're still a tier 8 tank destroyer with 800 damage on your gun. And if you can make good use of that 800 damage, in a tier 8 game, yeah, a medium tank just wouldn't be able to do anything. Wait, the enemy T-57 just crashed? Yeah, okay. So, the Jagdpanzer E-100 against two Waffenträgers auf E-100. And, well, our Jagdpanzer still has the artillery with him, but yeah. Wait. He got a gold fire thingy loaded. Yeah, well. That's goodbye to the artillery. Even with the 12.8, which is the better option on that tier 10 tank destroyer for me, he still would have been able to one-shot him, so. Seeing that the caliber of your guns won't change from tier 8 to tier 10, you shouldn't be surprised that you will find tier 9 playing mostly with a 15 centimeter gun and the tier 10. It will most likely be for the players that like sniping with fast shooting, that will play the 12.8 gun with 6 shells in its gun and 2 seconds of loading time between the shots. But you will also find that players will be shooting gold ammo with the 15 centimeter gun and do 800 damage per shot in your into your shoot. Yeah, it's or 4 times the 750 average damage, or 6 times the 500 damage. So it should be your own style how you will play the tanks. And being able to play most of the tanks from the tier 8 in multiple styles will actually be able to find the glass cannons quite useful. But as right now, he's shooting a 12.8 gun, and only one shell in this Jagdpanzer 100 will kill it. Arty or Waffenträger, doesn't matter. Yeah, he's dead. So, that was my second game, showing off the huge weakness of these tanks. Also, I was in a tier 10 game and did, well, 1650 damage in 2 shots. I could not bounce any shell from that E50M. And he, well, yeah, if he played it right, he would have been able to bounce my shots. And, well, yeah. 3300 damage by the Jagdpanzer E100. He should actually have been. Yeah. These tanks should have done a lot more damage than he did. Even I did more damage than them. So, was hit. I was hit 4 times, and yeah, that E50M just shoots 3 shots when I shoot 1 shot. And in to be able to do 1650 damage with 2 shots. In a tier 8 tank destroyer, it's the same as the ISU 152. And the Ferdinand can do a bit less, but also a lot, as does the Jagdpanzer 2. But any other tank destroyer would have used 4 shells for this damage. And it's a lot of damage to do in such a small amount of shots fired. And as you could see, I could penetrate the tier 10 medium tank even when he was angled a bit. I could still penetrate him. So, on to the next game. So, this time I am lucky. I did get into a tier 8 game. So, I am top tier. I'm using my 15cm gun again. And hopefully I won't be as unlucky as in the last tier 9 game I had, which would be a fortunate game if I wasn't shot by my team. So we're going to try not to get shot by a team this time and to get some sniper shots into the enemy without being spotted or shot back at. And then you will see that even the 15cm gun still is very accurate, even at a distance. I'm being followed by my teammates here, by the other two tier 8 tank destroyers. Don't know what gun they've got mounted, but if one of them has the 12.8 mounted, they should be able to penetrate better at a distance and be more accurate and fire faster. But looking at them, nope, they both got the 15cm mounted as well. So it seems the 15cm is the best choice in this game for the Waffenträger, for the Borsig Waffenträger. I am trying to get a shot on that light tank there, but I don't think he wants to get any shell at this moment. He does get shot at now, so he can't actually do anything anymore. See the T-44 there? So I'm going to place a shell in him, but I hit the rock in front of him. Backing off to reload, and I do seem to have lags here. And as it seems, I can hit that scout now. So let's see. Yep, I did hit him, just barely, but it still hit. But not showing you any more of the high damage rolls there. So because he only had just over 100 health. I hope that medium gets spotted again so I can put a shell in him. But seeming my team isn't doing very well there. I'm not depending on any spots. So, my two teammates here are unloading on those two tanks out there and almost killed them, as well as the tier 8 tank destroyer there. Well, I didn't expect that blind shot to hit an enemy, but if it did, he would He won't like that hit. Now we're ready to unload on anything that gets spotted there. But I don't think anyone will move forward. Still looking at the minimap and seeing my team there is losing quite a lot of players. I'm not really happy with the game as it goes there now. We do have a heavy tank standing there. That's the 110. Chinese tier 8 heavy tank. We're like, yeah, what's he doing there? So, there I did 800 damage on that new tank destroyer. He's like, yeah, well, there's three new tank destroyers out there. I'm in some trouble. And now he's dead. Only two shots that hit. Oh, I got hit in the engine. Any shot in the front can hit your engine. And that I didn't get killed by that shot surprised me. Just now I am surprised that I'm not killed, that my track did eat that shot. Right now, I'm very careful at how to move, and the heavy tank is coming to support me, but there's an enemy tank destroyer still there. And I do have to back off because I can't spot that medium tank before he spots me every time. I don't know why I actually should spot him faster. But I'm backing off now, moving to a position where I should be able to snipe. I'm actually being shot at again. I don't know what's shooting me. That T-4485 is aiming at me, it seems. Not at the 110. And I'm actually like, yeah, I'm not going to show myself if you are just going to aim at me. But that 110 is like, I'm just going to ignore him, going to circle around. Well, yeah. So there goes the T-28 prototype. Now I'm like, I knew where the last enemy was. I did get shot inside by him. And he moved. Now I'm moving out. I know their artillery can do a 72 kph. So I know I have to move fast. And hope my first shot with the damaged gun still goes in. Now I'm able to claim the kill on the artillery, because if I can't, like being bad luck right now, and even more bad luck, I track the enemy artillery. But having a turret, I get team killed. Again, I'm being shot at my team, by my team. And they forget that they got 800 raw damage.
coming out of that gun. Every time. Every shell will be 800 damage. And they, if you don't aim your shot, you will kill your teammates. Now, he's probably saying sorry that I killed you in Russian. But since I can't read Russian, I will not be sure if he said. Now, I hope I showed you that this tank does have some good advantages over other tanks. I hope you will consider the choice you make by going for this tank, and that if you go for this tank, you will make the right choice and not be going into the front line and getting yourself killed without doing anything, because with all those glass cannons, it's of no use if you are going to play it like a frontline tank. You have to play this tank as a rear guard, showing the enemy that even an 800 damage gun is very dangerous if shot at range. So, I was killed by my teammate again, but yeah, it didn't do a lot. Did show you that, again, if you hit a full health enemy, he will get 800 damage, mostly, because your gun does have 214 average penetration. As it shows, the teammates I have, both did over 3000 damage, and both have the 15 cm gun mounted, seeing at range shooting still about 750 damage average. It's just a gun that's going to be nerfed probably in the 9.0 patch, but if it's not going to be nerfed because the tank doesn't have any armor and you do need a team that will spot for you. Yeah. Seeing this now, these games, and seeing that my team in both games, or two of the three games, hit me, I am actually very unlucky in what kind of hits I get and stuff like that. I hope you guys did enjoy the information I gave you. I hope you guys are considering when you go buy this tank. You will not buy it for its armor or its frontline capacities, or just because it has a turret, but because it will be a terrific sniper. Tank you can have a lot of fun with, but if the gun won't behave, you will be like, ah, oh, I should have hit him. You will just get a big headache or just tear your hairs out. And yeah, just get angry. Well, seeming this tank does have four crew members, and skills will be used on this tank, because a tier 8 tank destroyer can be quite useful in tank companies. Except exactly a tank destroyer with a turret mounted and a big gun can be even more useful than a tank destroyer without a turret, or maybe even a medium tank or a heavy tank. So, about the crew skills, commander. It also is the radio operator. I would say something like recon or situational awareness, because it does give you more view range with the few hundred with the 400 meters you have. More view range is always useful. More signal range won't be needed because if you stand with at about 400 meters from your team, or a bit less because your team does have some spotting range as well, the view range will be most useful. The signal range, not really, while relaying. And sixth sense will be a major skill as well. But sixth sense, recon, and situational awareness are the major skills you have to go for on your commander. Because it's just, if you get spotted, you will be shot at, and every shot will penetrate. And if you can see enemies from even more distance, you will be less likely to get spotted. So for the gunner, first you could say snapshot because you have a turret and you will be rotating it a lot, or armorer because your gun will take quite a lot of damage. You got a big gun, every shot at your turret in the front near the gun will most likely damage the gun. Every shot in the front on the side of your turret will most likely damage your gun because it will go right through. And well, if you go right through the side, there is a gun behind it. Going for the driver, as you saw, my engine got shot in the first game, and a lot of more engines got shot, and my engine also got shot in the last game. So preventive maintenance would be something very useful. Also clutch braking to make the traverse speed even higher, and making sure that if you get to fight a medium tank or a light tank, having a lot of traverse speed will get your enemy in front of your gun. And smooth ride. Yeah, you will be moving, but seeming this is a sniper tank more than a frontline battle tank, smooth ride is not necessary. As a third skill, it could be useful, but I would say repairs or camouflage. Also, camouflage gets more useful if more crew members have it. For a loader, I would say safe stowage, and after that, camouflage and repairs or firefighting. Do not go for Brothers in Arms very fast in this tank, or intuition, since if you are spotted, you will be killed very fast in intuition. Yeah, the 10% line, you will probably not even survive after a 10% health left. Also adrenaline rush. Intuition, it will give you more useful about the shells you will be loading. If you will be loading a high explosive shell while you have an armor piercing shell loaded, you will have the chance that you instantly have a high explosive shell loaded and be able to shoot an enemy. But it won't be very useful. And the adrenaline rush, yeah, 10% hit points left in a tank without armor. Not even in close combats will it be able to save you. The camouflage skill will be more useful, and putting a camouflage on your tank as well as a camo net will make sure that you will be able to stay hidden a lot longer, get a shot more out, and survive. So very obvious, the camo net, also the enhanced gun laying drive, because if you look at the gun, Its aiming time 2.5 seconds. So a gun laying drive is very useful. You can also go for a large tank gun rammer and shoot faster. And instead of the gun laying drive, you could say a Binox. But further, anything not really. So the camo nets is the most obvious to load. If you use a camo net, you could go for a Binox. And well, if you use a camo net and Binox and want to be shooting enemies faster, large caliber tank gun rammer is very useful. But seeming mostly of the time you're in the back, and if you're left alone or the last one alive, the Binox aren't most useful. I would say the gun laying drive is more useful. Then you will start moving more, take up positions that go to positions that will be able to spot enemies before they spot you, and that means that binoculars will not be able to get up in time and spot the enemies for you. And having a gun laying drive then, and being able to aim in about 2.3 seconds, you will have a lot more use of your gun. And well, if you're behind a bush and your camo net is active and you have camouflage on it, you will see that the enemy will only spot you if they get closer, or you get your second shot off. And the moment you get your second shot off and move into cover, they will have to come to you again. And if you get your third shot off, they will most likely be dead. So I hope you will make good use of the tips and tricks I gave you. I hope you enjoyed the preview, and well, hopefully we'll see you guys on the battlefield, and good luck to you all!